I'm the gray-haired guy that gets the privilege and honor of saying a few words about my little princess and her new prince. I'm going to take you back to May 28, 1988. That was the day that your mom and I were doing the exact same thing that you and Cody are doing today. And that, by the way, is what I would call the most important day of my life. Right? The day we got married. Now I'm going to take you to the second most important day of my life. June 5th, 1992, your birthday. And when you were born and the nurses grabbed you, they laid you down on this table and I leaned down and I said, "Hi, sweetheart." And you rolled over and you looked me in the eyes with those pretty big eyes of yours and that strawberry birthmark on your cheek as if to say, "Hi, Dad." And that was a really special moment. I was so touched by that, that when I got home, I set up a tripod and I set up a camera. And I put that camera on record and I was talking to that camera as if I were talking to you. So the first thing I said was, "You absolutely made Mom and I the happiest ever. That's the happiest day of our life." And I remember looking in the camera and said, "Katie, I promise you, I will try to be the best dad I know how to be, right?" And I said, "I am going to play with you. I am going to dress up if I have to. I'm going to take you to Disneyland. And I'm going to take you to learn how to dance, but I'm not going to teach you. You're going to dance on your own. I'm going to go to the recitals and I'm going to watch you dance and I'm going to look at you as if you're the only one dancing on that stage." And that's what I did, Katie. I didn't see everybody else. And I know there's some other dancers in here. I'm sorry. I just saw you.
Cody has always been really loyal to me. I had a plane trip to go to Europe and one of my buddies dropped out on me, so I called up Cody and unbeknownst to his mother, he decided to quit his job and we planned a 30-day backpack over to Europe. But that's when Kate kind of came into the story. Cody was FaceTiming Kate the second night when we were in Rome, and when he got off the phone, he told her that he loved her. And after he hung up on the phone, I was kind of like, "You just met this girl not even a month ago and you're already telling her that you love her." And then we get back and he decides to move to Denver. I still haven't met Kate at this point, but Cody was already loyal to Kate. He was telling her he loves her after a month. And he obviously already knew that right then at that point that he was meeting her wife. And for me, though, it was kind of difficult because I felt like I might be losing my best friend. But then I decided to quit my job and move to Denver.
First and foremost, I just want to say that you look absolutely beautiful. Cody, you don't look too bad yourself. Katie always joked how she would never get married because she was the one without a boyfriend when we were graduating college. We all thought that, you know, if you didn't have a boyfriend leaving college, that we didn't know where you're going to find one. And for those of you that don't know Katie, Katie's not her prince. I know that Jake briefly spoke on it. It was a beautiful, brisk evening, Cinco de Mayo. What better day to go drink margaritas with your girlfriends than a day to celebrate Cinco de Mayo? Katie explained the exact same thing to me. She was like, "I met this guy across the bar. We locked eyes. He wouldn't talk to me for a minute, so it was really awkward, and we kept staring at each other. And I was like, is he gonna come talk to me, or is he not gonna come talk to me?" And eventually he came to talk to her, and the rest is history. like Katie and Sirius know, we've been through so much together, and you've always been by my side. I always know that I can consider you as my sister and my best friend. We can go months without seeing each other and pick up right where we left off. And you have given me so much advice over the years, and I know that I can count on you for anything. And I know that the second I met Cody that he was the one. I really couldn't have picked a better husband for my best friend to marry.
Caitlin Marie Diller. I need to spend the rest of my life with you.
I tell you all the time how you're my favorite human, but when I really stop and think about all the things that make up this world, it's pretty astronomical to realize just how many living, breathing forms of life there are.
Your smile is my sunshine. Your laugh is my summer breeze.
Plants and animals aside, there are billions of humans that exist in the world right now, and of those billions, yours is the one that I am privileged to share a life with.
Your spirit is like a magic carpet right through the Rockies. You didn't know I was so smooth with words, did you?
If someone were to ask me what my favorite thing about Earth is, my answer without a doubt or a second of hesitation would be you.
What I'm trying to say is you're so strong, independent, and passionate, and so kind and caring.
Every night before I fall asleep, I tell God, thank you for my Cody. You may wake me up in the middle of the night from the conversations you're having with clients in your sleep. But even still, I put my arm around you and drift off, thanking God for you again.
You're my world, and you're my best friend, and I'm glad you love and serve.
Thank you for being my Cody, for every ounce of happiness you've given me, and for this life that we get to share together forever. I love you so much.
I now pronounce you husband and wife. Thank you.